If you have a single quad element, like this one for the 2 meter band, you have the feed point like this, with the common choke, and the impedance will be above 100 ohms. But if you have another loop, the same dimension, then you can easily add it, connect it together. So this one to this point and this one to that point, and then it becomes a double quad, biquad, or how it is called. Impedance will be in the order of 50 ohm. So that's good. Positioned this way, you have horizontal polarization, and this way you have vertical polarization. It is not omnidirectional, it has some directivity and therefore also some gain. Here I did the same for the 70 centimeter band, vertically polarized, directly connected to the coax cable, and when the coax cable is fastened with some tape to a broomstick, I could stick it out of the window. Another one for 70 centimeter band, without the cable, with the connector directly connected to it. If you want to have some gain, additional gain, then you can add reflectors. One here, and one here, because the current maximums are about here, here and here. So with three of those reflectors, you can add some additional gain. Here we have a double quad for the 23-24 centimeter band. It was used for ATV without a balun. So the coax cable is directly connected to, these are connected together and these are connected together, and the coax cable is connected to it like this, and it has a front to back ratio of more than 20 dB and a gain of almost 8 dBi. So it's a very nice antenna. By adjusting the distance between the element and the reflector plate, also influence the impedance a bit, to match it to the 50 ohm or the impedance you desire. Simple way to experiment with this kind of antennas, and in this case I mounted it behind the other dishes, so it is pointing under 80 degrees the other direction, but at least you can do some experiments. See you!